We present an arthroscopic technique of an indirect reconstruction of the dorsal scapholunate interosseous ligament for scapholunate instability. This technique is indicated for patients with acute injury in which the scapholunate ligament still maintains same potential for healing. Scapholunate instability are evaluated and classified from radiocarpal portals 3-4 and 4-5 and midcarpal, radial and ulnar portals. The fibrous and inflammatory tissue from the dorsal portion of the scapholunate ligament is cleaned with a saver. According to where the ligament has been detached, cruentation of the insertion of the scapholunate is performed to stimulate healing. With arthroscopic visualization through the 3-4 portal, we introduce a drill guide through the 4-5 portal and place it in the center of the lunate. A hole 8 mm depth is created with a 2 mm drill bit. Any soft tissue surrounding and inside the drill hole is cleared. A 2.5 mm pushlock knuckles loaded with a 2 mm fiber tape is impacted to insert the tack portion of the anchor into the hole and lock the fiber tape. The portals are switched. With the arthroscope insert through the 4-5 portal, the fiber tape is retrieved from the 3-4 portal. From the 3-4 portal, we introduce a 1.2 mm keyware into the proximal pole of the scaphoid under arthroscopic control. A 10 mm hole is drilled in the proximal pole of the scaphoid with a 3.2 mm cannulated drill bit. Any soft tissue surrounding and inside the drill hole is cleared. We load the fiber tape in the fourth eyelet for a 3.5 mm Swiss lock and insert the Swiss lock into the hole through the 3-4 portal. A slow and constant pressure downward will allow the Swiss lock to insert and autotension the fiber tape. With the arthroscope in the 4-5 portal, we control that there is a good contact between the fiber tape and the dorsal interosseous ligament. Cut off any excess of fiber tape. Complete restoration of the scapholunate joint stability is checked. First, with the arthroscope in the midcarpal ulnar portal and the probe in the midcarpal radial portal, then portals are switched. And finally, with the arthroscope in the midcarpal radial portal and the probe in the midcarpal ulnar portal, the gap is closed so the probe can no longer enter the gap.